Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. In today's video, we are going to understand about Fabry-Perot interferometer. So, the main aim of this interferometer is to align the Fabry-Perot interferometer and to study the fringes pattern. In year 1899, Charles Fabry and Alfred Perot developed a type of interferometer by using two partial mirrors and aligned them parallel to one another, forming a reflective cavity. When rays of an occurrent light source enters in the such type of cavity and reflects forth and back, it results in a circular fringes pattern. This fringes pattern is similar to the Michelson interferometer fringes pattern, but the fringes in this Fabry-Perot interferometer are more brighter, more thinner and more widely spaced, and which can be easily used to calculate the different types of parameters of the optics. So now we move on to the experimental setup, and we will set up the interferometer with this kit and observe the fringes pattern. So this is the interferometer, Fabry-Perot interferometer kit providing from Tesca. The order code for this kit is 192.04401.6. This is the Fabry-Perot interferometer kit. The main accessories with this kits are the IC regulated power source and the LED power source, which is used while doing experiment. This is the power source which will be used, and this is the Fabry-Perot etalon setup. And this is the collimating lens and through hole slide which is provided with this. The light source will be incident with this light source, and this is the fringes pattern screen, which will be the fringes pattern will be exposed to this screen and observe the circular pattern of fringes. The user manual are also provided with this kit to better understanding of the experiment and to perform the experimental setup. So our first on the main aim of this experiment kit is to align the Fabry-Perot interferometer and study the fringes. For this we required an interferometer kit, which is this, and also we required a diode light source, laser source. So the schematic diagram of a Fabry-Perot interferometer is shown in this figure. In this figure, the incident rays are incident to this partial mirror. This partial mirror are of 80/20 in partiality. So when the rays are incident to this mirror from this and from this side, this is the 20% where it is the non-partial and partially the partial mirrors. So the rays pass through this and incident to the mirror in front of them. The front mirror is also a partial mirror, so the rays are immediately incident forth and back in this cavity, which is the cavity made in the by air. So both the rays are transmitted out of the mirror and also reflected inside the cavity. So these patterns are in further contimated with the convex lens, and when we pointed these rays to a point or a screen, we will observe a fringes pattern with this experiment. So I will explain you the different parts of this kit now. Both the mirrors M1 and M2 are mounted on a kinematic mounts for adjusting mirrors manually perpendicular to each other. The mirror M1 is fixed while the mirror M2 is movable. So the mirror M1 is fixed and the M2 is movable mirror. This mirror can be moved with this micrometer, and there are two micrometer. The mirror is placed on a carriage which can be moved with this micrometer. So you can see the mirror is moving with this micrometer. There are two micrometer. This is the coarse micrometer and this is the fine micrometer. The coarse movement or the fine movement of the carriage, one turn of the coarse travel micrometer displaces mirror by 1 millimeter, and one turn of fine travel micrometer displaces the mirror by 0.025 millimeter. So we can say the division on the micrometer is equivalent to 0.0005 millimeter displacement. So this is the least count of this kit, and now we align the interferometer setup with given circuit diagram. Now we are going to set up the Fabry-Perot interferometer setup. For this we first power on the light source with this IC regulated power supply. Now the laser is on, you can see. Now we align the laser source across 30 to 50 centimeter away from the instrument, and we will try to pass this laser source as much as can we pass through this pinhole, and the laser should be incident to the center of the mirrors. Now the laser is incidenting to the center of these mirrors. Now we will set the reflection of this mirror to truly inserted in the light source. For this we will move this screw and move the reflection to the laser source incidenting. So this is the reflection you see at the pinhole plate. Now this reflection of the mirror of the laser beam should be incident through this hole and to be incident to the laser light. So for this we move this screws, or these screws of adjustment, so the laser source incident moves, you can see in the plate as well, very carefully. So the reflection of the laser beam properly incident to the its source where it is coming. The optics practicals needs lot of practice and lot of patience to do. So one can need very very high practice, which is makes perfect doing the practicals. So now our laser beam has been set up through incident angle. Now we move on to the further step. We'll place the white card in the observation field, and we will see the laser source display a comet like tail like this for back of the card. The alignments, now we will see, we can say the alignment has not been properly reached. For this we will need to adjust the screws of M2 mirror. This is the M2 mirror, so the all points are collide in one point, you can see here. All the points are colliding. We can finally collide all the points in one. So this is the one point now. Now the alignment has properly done. Now we observe the fringes pattern. For this we will use this collimating lens to this pinhole screen very carefully without moving any object. Properly tighten this lens here, and the fringes pattern
are now can observe the series of multi-beam fringes. The fringes are observed incidenting at the white paper, which cannot be seen in this bright light. For this, we will have to dim the light or the cut the power source of lights, so the in a darker light we will see the fringes. So after dimming the light or lighting or switching off the light, we can easily see the fringes pattern here. Now as we move the fine micrometer, we will see the lighter and darker fringes pattern, which are fringes are moving perfectly, and these fringes are more thinner and brighter than Michelson interferometer. So this is our practical of Fabry-Perot interferometer for observing the fringes pattern with the Fabry-Perot Etalon or Fabry-Perot Etalon practical kit. The video quality may be not as proper as I can see from the eyes here. So when you perform the practical on this kit, you will see the proper and very brighter fringes over here. When you set the proper alignment, you will get the proper fringes from this setup. When the light was off, we have seen the fringes pattern from this Fabry-Perot interferometer. When the alignments are proper, you will easily get the interferometer. But so now we have seen the fringes pattern when we last shut off the light on this screen. The fringes are right now also incidenting multi-beam interference rings, but it cannot be seen in this bright light. So for this, you have to do this practical in a dark room or in a dim light room for proper output of this interferometer kit. Now if you find any difficulty for setting up the interferometer, you can contact to the Tesca Technologies Private Limited, or you need very hard practice to do the interferometer experiment, because the optic experiment need very high practice to perform to get the output. So you need to do the experiment many times, again and again you need to set up the experiment, and you will get the output when you perfectly able to set up the experiment.